The story you are about to hear is true. Only the names have been changed. Only the names have been changed.
Item hash, SCP-2780, Object Class, Safe Special Containment Procedures. The house containing SCP-2780 is to be occupied by Foundation security officers belonging to the Temporal Division to prevent unauthorized access. To prevent unnecessary attention from neighbors and municipal authorities, the on-site security officers should portray themselves as a couple in a committed relationship to all neighbors and passers-by. The house will be deeded in their name for legal purposes. All doors, windows, and locks have been upgraded to bullet and shatterproof variations. Security officers are encouraged to continue regular maintenance of the house over the years of occupation duty. The Foundation will arrange a transfer of possession between sets of security personnel that resembles conventional moving out and moving in activities over the course of the Foundation's period of active occupation. To avoid potential manifestation of temporal paradoxes, the Foundation must cease active occupation of the house by 2089 February 11th and put the house for sale. The Foundation must also ensure that the house is purchased by Sarah Fulvia at an affordable price, no more than 14,000 and slightly below median rates in the neighborhood. Recording devices throughout the house will continue monitoring activity within the house to ensure that the timeline remains coherent. The rear bedroom of the house, the active zone of SCP-2780, is to be monitored for continued activity during present containment. Because SCP-2780 was contained successfully on 2016 August 6, based on the Foundation's current understanding of the anomaly, Foundation agents should be able to arrest Sarah Fulvia, remove her nightstand, and resume active occupation of the house by 2091 August 6 without consequences to the timeline. However, because Sarah Fulvia appears to remain in the house without any Foundation intervention as late as 2092 April 30, based on the time of this writing plus 75 years, and appears to have gained some awareness of the Foundation's containment efforts through unknown means, one monitoring of SCP-2780 will continue. Description: SCP-2780 is an auditory anomaly isolated to the rear bedroom of the house presently located at 618 Evergreen Street in Dresden, TN, United States. While in the rear bedroom of the house, an individual or recording device will hear any sounds or conversations occurring in that room at that time exactly 75 years in the future after that point. Individuals outside the room will not hear anything anomalous. Individuals standing in the threshold of the door will hear sounds only if one or both of their ears is inside the confines of the room. Additionally, if a brown wooden nightstand with a drawer is placed in the northeast corner of the room, with the drawer opening towards the west, an individual occupying the room 75 years in the future can transfer small objects into the present time. Scientific modifications of the environment have confirmed all of the particulars of this arrangement. Any form of wood can be used, so long as it is brown. Staining is permissible. The furniture must be a freestanding drawered object intended for placement beside a bed. The furniture must be in that particular corner, up to approximately 40 centimeters away from flush with either wall, and facing in that particular direction, plus minus 4 degrees in any direction, otherwise no transference can occur. Evidence suggests that a similar object exists in that location in the house 75 years in the future. However, experimentation has not yet had the opportunity to treat the future as an independent variable. Addendum 2780A. Recovery description: SCP-2780 was discovered when Foundation operatives in Region 166, West Tennessee, Kentucky, obtained information regarding court proceedings for Brianna Rini Tucker, held on multiple charges of selling illegal substances and possession of illegal substances with intent to sell. Foundation interest was piqued by court documents that suggested that several of the substances were not identifiable by any laboratory that the court had contacted, as well as Ms. Tucker's insistence that all of the drugs were medical in nature and had no risk of dependency or addiction. Standard methods were used to contain Ms. Tucker and erase all records of her arrest and prior existence. Ms. Tucker was initially hesitant to discuss how she procured the drugs she had been selling, but chemical interrogation yielded more comprehensive information. Ms. Tucker informed the Foundation that she had discovered SCP-2780 after moving into the residence at 618 Evergreen Street and overhearing unusual conversation. After ruling out conventional sources for the conversation, she used careful attention to the unusual dialect and vocabulary, limited use of hallucinogenic chemicals, and some experience with common cultural tropes of time travel fiction and deduced SCP-2780's anomalous nature. The city of Dresden, TN was at that time in the process of burying a 75-year time capsule as part of a civic pride campaign enacted after a local election. Ms. Tucker included in that time capsule a letter to be mailed to the occupant of her address in the year 2090, informing her that she was capable of overhearing her conversations in the future and proposing a trade arrangement. Ms. Tucker had already made notice of, and informed the future occupant, who she had identified as Sarah Fulvia, about SCP-2780's secondary effect, which she had determined after recovering several small items in her nightstand and overhearing Miss Fulvia complaining about having lost them. Miss Tucker proposed that Miss Fulvia do some research into inexpensive, over-the-counter pharmaceutical items available in stores in 2090 that were significantly more expensive and difficult to acquire in 2015. Miss Tucker included a list of suggested medicines, including antibiotics, antihistamines, antivirals, antiretrovirals, painkillers, and anti-inflammatory drugs. Miss Tucker also suggested that she could invest money in a savings account at the local Realfoot Bank branch in Martin, a nearby town, and Miss Fulvia would be more than repaid by 2090 by way of interest. Finally, Miss Tucker suggested that if Miss Fulvia wanted to continue a line of communication in chronological order, she could enter the rear bedroom, respond verbally to Miss Tucker's letter, and then go to a predetermined location, in the backyard of the house, and dig in a particular spot to find the next message, which Miss Tucker would write after hearing Miss Fulvia's response. According to Miss Tucker, she waited in the room containing SCP-2780 until Miss Fulvia read the letter. Miss Fulvia entered the room and began responding audibly to Miss Tucker, giving obvious indications of discomfort but tentatively agreeing to the core idea of Miss Tucker's plan. However, Miss Fulvia countered with several pieces of relevant information about the time period between 2015 and 2090 that required significant modification to the particulars of the plan, specifically, the branch of Realfoot Bank that Miss Tucker recommended no longer existed, nor did the Realfoot Bank Corporation as a whole. In fact, the concept of a physical bank was somewhat obsolescent by Miss Fulvia's time. The American dollars that Miss Tucker would be in possession of would be considered worthless and, in fact, possibly illegal. Miss Fulvia was unsure as to the exact parameters of the law. An ill-described two-historical epoch, referred to as the 40s thing, had caused significant internal disorder in the area presently known as the United States. As a result, Miss Fulvia said, it would be nearly impossible to trust almost any organized institution, governmental or private, to handle money through that period of time, as nearly all of them were either destroyed, dismantled, audited, robbed, or generally became unreliable. However, Miss Fulvia suggested that if Miss Tucker could somehow arrange for someone to intercept the payments in early 2041 inches, which was suggested to be the cusp of the crisis period, hold on to the money for a period of 3-4 years, convert them into a privately backed currency known as American New Dollars, and then invest that money in One Arcadia Dynamics Corporation, the investments should remain intact until Miss Fulvia's time. Finally, Miss Fulvia told Miss Tucker that if she wanted to try the scheme regardless, she could include some amount of rare metals in her next message, which Miss Fulvia could use as a down payment and begin the process. Miss Tucker told the Foundation that she replied in the next letter by including some pieces of heirloom platinum jewelry in the jar that she buried in the agreed-upon location. After burying the jar, including a message identifying where the next drop point would be, she removed the first shipment of pharmaceuticals from the nightstand. Miss Tucker has, to date, buried 29 jars in various locations. Because she has received pharmaceuticals in exchange for each burial, Foundation temporal theorists strongly advise that the Foundation not interfere with or intercept the jars for fear of causing a temporal paradox. When asked by the Foundation how Miss Tucker plans to circumvent the financial crises forecast in the 2040s, she has replied that she got no fucking idea, but apparently I'm gonna get that shit done somehow. Or maybe you will. I guess you have to at least help, right? Among questions that the Foundation has not yet been able to resolve regarding SCP-2780, Foundation researchers are interested in learning who, when, and how the jars will be intercepted in the 2040s, when or if exactly the phenomenon will reverse and begin projecting into the past, rather than receiving from the future. Why the Foundation in 2090 has not already contained or addressed SCP-2780 in any way. Addendum 2780-B, sample of medications recovered in Brianna Renee Tucker's possession, acquired via SCP-2780, Tigerspore and TM brand Tigecycline C sulfate ointment, manufactured by AdPharmatage, for treatment of topical injuries. 3. Atlas RTM brand gene therapy powder, manufactured by GMC in conjunction with AdPharmatage. This is an athletic supplement that prevents subcutaneous fat formation and channels the excess energy into muscle generation. Panadol TM brand oral antibiotic, antiviral combination capsule, manufactured by New Federated Health Industries in association with AdPharmatage. Microscopic analysis of the chemical makeup of the Panadol sample suggested some similarities to SCP-500, though the actual function of the comparable chemical structures remains a mystery. Nanian TM brand fertility enhancement and pregnancy megavitamin supplement, manufactured by New Federated Health Industries in association with AdPharmatage. Nanian releases nanoassemblers inside the human body that regulate uterine and ovarian conditions to improve odds of fertilization, prevent ichthyosis, reduce blood pressure and release endorphins to reduce physical symptoms of stress, and artificially introduce essential neonatal vitamins, nutrients, and protein into the bloodstream. The box containing the single blister pack of Nanian also advertised that it reduced the likelihood of preeclampsia by 85% and spontaneous miscarriage by 82% in clinical trials. Castrotin TM brand sexual cessator. No manufacturer listed. Disrupts production of all hormones involved in sexual desire or expression. A notice on the side of the box references a coupon that can cancel the price of this medication if it has been required by court or company order. Basacine TM brand anti-anxiety drugs from AdPharmatage. Testing suggests that the drug may act on certain inactive neurotransmitters in the human brain and effectively heighten latent telepathic abilities in humans, causing humans under its influence to better recognize how they are perceived by individuals around them, reducing personal insecurity and anxiety. The packaging recommends taking it in conjunction with Levolent TM brand neurostabilizers, also available from AdPharmatage. Several tubes of generic moisturizing lotion with Tigecycline sulfate supplements and vitamins evidently designed to rapidly heal and disinfect self-inflicted scratch damage related to a disease known as sarcoplasmosis. Phrasing on the label suggests this is the most effective treatment for sarcoplasmosis yet developed, and mentions that it is safe for emergency application directly onto optical and genital membranes. The vocabulary and level of detail in the instructions on the tube suggest it is meant to be applied to the patient by a friend without medical training, likely in a non-medical facility with many other individuals with the same affliction. Several packages of tea, generic testosterone supplements, completely unmarked other than a government warning against overuse from Dixieland Federated HSA. Footnotes 1. This is based on observations of SCP-2780 that include recordings of her frequent comments on the Foundation and its inefficacious handling of the containment effort, as well as several epithets of a personal and often sexual nature, too. Miss Tucker's ability to describe the event was somewhat limited. Miss Fulvia herself was not well acquainted with even recent American history, and her perspective was somewhat biased, judging from some of the logical inconsistencies in the story. 3. Tigecycline is presently, as of 2016, only available in intravenous form. A market for its production as topical cream implies that ordinary surface and environmental bacteria in 2090 has unusually great resistance to antibiotics.